This video is brought to you by Clean My Mac X. Choosing between the baseline M1 MacBook Pro and the 16GB upgrade is a bit like being Jean-Claude Van Damme stretched between two Volvo trucks. You know it will be one or the other, but you secretly hope that it will be the less expensive model. There is a reasonable choice, however, but I realized that after I made the mistake of first purchasing a baseline 8GB M1 MacBook Pro. Let me explain. Hey, Iskren here, but feel free to call me E. It is now clear to me that I should have opted, or in my case, waited for the 16GB model instead of rushing and getting the underpowered one, back when all the M1s were released. That dilemma of mine was completely shattered as soon as I took the plunge and my 16GB order arrived. At that point, I was confident that I can finally sell my 16-inch Intel maxed out MacBook Pro for good. So I'm here to tell you that when we talk about M1 machines, RAM does matter. And while reviewing this second M1 of mine, I'd like to point out later why 8GB of extra memory might make or break your experience. So let's take a step back and see what we're dealing with. This is an 8-core CPU and 8-core GPU with a 16-core Neural Engine configuration with 16GB of unified memory and base storage of 512GB, costing roughly $1,700. The form factor is the same as the MacBooks of yesteryear, with a huge downside of having only two USB-C ports on the left side. This tiny thing, however, in those specs is extremely unique, because for the first time since the 11-inch iPad Pro, that much power and potential comes in such a small package. Actually, ever since I completely moved over to this very M1, my iPad Pro had to live up to my MacBook Pro because the Mac is a Mac and I can do a lot more with it, but also because the Mac, in this case, lasts longer than the iPad's battery, which to this point was one of my iPad's superpowers. There was a time when I even completely stopped using my iPad because of the Mac. Of course, when the honeymoon period was over, I eventually came back and grabbed the tablet again because of its unique versatility. Anyway, I recently released a video showcasing my top 10 ways of using my iPad Pro. So if you're interested, click on this link right here. So all form factor with this M1, but compact and powerful. That's all that matters to me. The 20 hours of claimed battery life is no joke with all M1 battery powered machines, and not glaring at the battery percentage, or in fact, not thinking about the battery at all, is something to brag about. It's a bit like having an electric vehicle and not suffering from range anxiety. Even when editing or playing games, this laptop lasts for ages. Sure, if I don't use a laptop as my desk setup, the screen might come small for some projects, but it still does the job okay, despite the old bezels that we have all come to despise already. The panel is plenty bright, color accurate, and I embrace the bezels by rounding the corners, making everything seem more like an iPad Pro. The webcam these days is the same as before, but paired with the new internals supposedly delivers better results. Although, if you ask me, it's still as embarrassing, so yeah. The speakers, though, are great, and although not as immersive as my previous 16-inch laptop, they deliver satisfying results. I use this computer to do all my creative work, from development tasks to graphic design on Affinity Photo and Designer to complex video edits in Final Cut Pro to occasional gaming. This M1 MacBook Pro is handling everything like a champ. I fit all this power in a small messenger bag, and I don't have to carry a charger daily. This is my one and only all-rounder that I can rely on for everything. That wasn't the case with my previous 8GB model though, and I really want to bring this up to your attention because I know the temptation and desire to save cash. RAM is important. I'd go as far as to say that with an extra 8GB of RAM, I am witnessing a totally different machine, like a pro and non-pro laptop. I did not expect this, to be honest. When I first started to use my baseline 8GB model, I was taking things slow. With Intel-based apps and Rosetta, I wanted to gradually see what's what, and for the first 4 to 6 weeks, everything seemed perfect. I could easily work off of it, I could play games, You know, and I could never get tired of the endless battery life. As I was introducing more and more complicated workflows, and as work began to pile up, I was naturally speeding up my multitasking. And at that point, I began witnessing dodgy performance when doing multiple resource-intensive tasks. For example, I would have to quickly retouch a photo, then crop or draw a graphic, which I'd have to export for final cut. And I would switch back and forth between my tools until at one point, things would either freeze up for a second or I would behold the beach ball of death. Force quitting and occasional restarts slowly started to turn into daily habits, and clean my Mac X would jump up with multiple warnings of exhausted RAM, which meant I would have to stop and think of what I can sacrifice to finish what I initially intended to do. At one point, I wanted to run Parallels on Windows, which I know a lot of people will want to use for work as well, and having that little memory bandwidth would seriously start to question my choice of configuration. I became very obsessed with what I'm dealing with at any given moment, doing my best not to exceed the machine's limitations. I would either work on a graphic task, quit, and then open the next tool that I need, or I would simply do a restart knowing that it would be mandatory to finalize everything that I wanted to do. Now don't get me wrong, for 2 months I was undoubtedly capable of doing all my work, but at a cost. As snappy and brisk as the baseline 8GB M1 was at basic tasks, it would become hesitant and slow when I needed the most, especially after a few days of work. Clean My Mac X, by the way, has helped me a lot during my initial M1 struggles, and I'm confident that anyone who's running a slower Mac or an older machine should definitely give Clean My Mac X a try. With it, I can monitor all my computer components and vitals and swiftly clean and free up not only my hard disk space, but also get rid of anything that is clogging my memory resources. Every few days, Clean My Mac X would remind me to do a simple scan that unequivocally would clear up at least few gigs of disk space and free up precious RAM. Clean My Mac X is my Swiss Army knife for my Mac because it is always there, inconspicuously helping me do all sorts of maintenance, like properly uninstall apps or getting a glimpse and manage my disk space thanks to the awesome interactive map of my entire drive. With this tool, I can locate massive old files that were swept under the rug, so to speak, protect my laptop from malware, and even keep everything up to date. Think of it as the most user-friendly fixer for your Mac, so be sure to head over to the first link in the description below and install Clean My Mac X today. So be honest about your needs. Think twice of the way you use your Mac, knowing that you'll most likely use it the next few years. 8GB of RAM is okay for many, but for some it is not, because that extra 8GB will make an M1 computer feel like something twice as capable. If your daily use, however, doesn't require special resource-hungry tools, I'd even recommend the M1 MacBook Air because, unlike memory, the active cooling on the Pro won't be as necessary. The Air is cheaper, sleeker, and despite some compromises like, you know, one less GPU core, a bit smaller battery, and slightly dimmer display, it is just as good for the average consumer. As for the MacBook Pro, I think it should only exist in a 16GB variant, and unless Apple releases an updated version with hopefully more ports, multi-display support, potentially an SD card reader, and a sleeker design with smaller bezels, this 13-inch 16GB Triumph is all I would ask for. If you enjoyed this video, check out my M1 playlist where I talk about setting up my new M1 Mac and much more. If you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comment section below or ping me on Twitter. As always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is Z, over and out.